Amen. Hey, well, praise the Lord, everyone. God bless you. Good to be in your hearing today and a little bit in your seeing or a combination of. You know, I normally do the midday matter, so you get to hear me, but rarely do you get to see me unless you doing a picture, a new picture or whatever. But anyway, just wanted to come into your hearing real quick today. God laid something on my heart, and it really pricked me. So I just wanted to share this with you, and prayerfully, you'll be able to get something from it. And I'm mainly talking to the men today. Amen. God bless you there, Brother Jones. Amen. God bless you. Thanks for popping in. Amen. But again, I wanted to share something with you. I'm going to the book of Titus. Titus. Amen. Titus. And I'm going to look at the second chapter. Titus, the second chapter. So let me put this into your hearing. Amen. It says, but as for you, speak the things which are proper for sound doctrine, that the older men be sober, reverent, temperate, sound in faith, in love, in patience. The older women, likewise, that they be reverent in behavior, not slanderers, not given to much wine, teachers of good things, that they admonish the young women to love their husbands, to love their children, to be discreet, chaste, homemakers, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God may not be blasphemed. Excuse me. Likewise, exhort the young men to be sober-minded, in all things showing yourself to be a pattern of good works and doctrine, showing integrity, reverence, incorruptibility. Verse 8, sound speech that cannot be condemned, that one who is an opponent may be ashamed, having nothing evil to say of you. Amen. Once again, I read Titus, the second chapter, verses 1 through 8. Amen. And the thing that I wanted to point out, and you'll kind of see in the title, as I'm saying, Lord, forgive me for being a bad example. Because when I begin to read this thing, it says, in all things, showing yourself to be a pattern of good works, in doctrine, showing integrity, reverence, incorruptibility, and it goes on. But what I found out about myself is that, man, I've made a lot of mistakes. Amen. I made a lot of mistakes. Now, I've been in this faith walk for roughly 20 years now, and I've always had a heart to please God, to love people, to be good to people, to avail myself, and just love hard and all those other things. But the thing that I found out is I've missed the mark quite often. Amen. So to you, especially to my young brothers in the faith, and even to the unbelievers, forgive me for being a bad example, because the thing that I was supposed to be showing you, amen, I failed. Amen. In other words, am I saying that I did everything wrong? No. But let me start by saying this. Even as a father and a husband, when I gave my life to Christ, I said, okay, God, I want to be a better husband. I want to be a better father. I want to serve you. And next thing you know, amen, I'm serving hard in the church. I'm doing the things that I believe God would have me to do. Again, I'm serving, amen. I'm being obedient. But I also want to be a provider for my family. So yeah, I'm trying to make the next rank. I'm trying to get promoted. But what I found out was in my attempts, amen, to be promoted, I forgot to be a father and a husband. In my attempts to be all that God would want me to be in the church, amen, trying to be the best saint, if you will, I forgot to be a father and a husband, amen. I hope you get the gist. So the thing that I'm trying to tell us is, once again, verse 7 says, in all things, showing yourself to be a pattern of good works, amen. So yeah, on the job, they can say, yeah, you got good works, amen. When I being a part of another ministry, oh yeah, you got good works, that brother faithful, he here all the time. But what about being a husband and a father? Amen. My wife couldn't say that I've always put them first. Amen. My children can't say that I've always put them first. Why? I was trying to be the best soldier. Amen. I was trying to be the best saint, but I forgot to be a father and a husband. Amen. I'm hoping that this thing will help someone today. Amen. I remember growing up as a kid, as I got older and thinking back, man, where was the men that was supposed to be an example for me? Where was the men that was supposed to speak into my life? Where was the men that was supposed to speak into me and tell me that, hey, you can do this, or to tell me, hey, you're out of order, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that? Where were the men? Amen. But see, and because of the things that I saw or that I failed to receive, I said, I want to be different. I want to do something different. But guess what? I find myself doing the same things. Now, I would say this. I lived a different lifestyle. And I'm saying, because I've been living for Christ. Amen. I've been living for Christ. But the part that I failed, and where I failed at, is I forgot to invest back into my young brothers. Amen. I forgot to invest back into my own sons. Amen. I forgot, you know, yeah, we have conversations. Yeah, they say, well, here go dad lecturing again. But because I was trying to be good at all these other things, I really forgot to invest into our children. Amen. So what are you talking about? I'm telling us that, hey, forgive me for being a bad example. Forgive me for being a bad example for you. Amen. I have nephews, amen, and again, family members that I love dearly, amen, and I forgot to be an example for them. I forgot to be an example. Instead of being a godly example, once again, I'm reading here Titus, the second chapter, in verses 1 through 8, but right here in verse 7, it says, in all things, showing yourself to be a pattern of good works and doctrine, showing integrity, reverence, incorruptibility, but showing yourself to be a pattern of good works. Amen. I failed to be a pattern of good works. Amen. Yeah, I serve God. Yeah, I ain't been out there slipping, dipping in midnight. I ain't been out there tripping. Amen. But what I have failed to do, again, is to invest, amen, my time unto some other young men. Instead, they, you know, the example that I gave was, okay, yeah, if you do good, you can drive this. Amen. If you got good credit, amen, you can drive this. You can live here. Amen. Only thing that I was, the example that I was giving you was about hairstyles, amen, and tennis shoes, amen, about jewelry, about how you dress and whatever, you know. But forgive me for being a bad example, amen. I should have been investing into you, my young brother, amen. I should have been giving you some practical applications for life, amen. But forgive me for being a bad example. I got it now, amen. And I'm striving to be better, amen. Because you need an example. You need someone to tell you, hey, pull your pants up, amen. You need someone. Somebody should have been investing in speaking into your life that, hey, look, that you might not want to do that now, amen. You may want to wait and do that at a later age. But because I didn't invest the time when I did say it, or when I tried to say it, you weren't hearing me because I never invested the time before, amen. So forgive me for being a bad example, amen, young brother, amen. But see, the thing is, amen, we get upset even today with the court system, amen. We say, well, amen, look at the jurors, man. You know, man, look all them folks on the jury, as the jury. You know, how come ain't none of us up there? Well, because I was a bad example. I didn't tell you, amen, if you don't have a license. I didn't tell you if you're not a registered voter, amen, then they're not going to call you to be a juror, amen. I didn't tell you that if you continue to get in trouble, amen, and get a record, that you can't sit on the jury. So forgive me for being a bad example, amen. So I can't get upset, amen, with the system and how the system is set up, amen. But what I can do is be a better example to you, young man. Hallelujah. Amen. But let's look at the text real quick. I want to reel us in. Once again, Titus, the second chapter, amen, beginning at verse 1. It said, but as for you, speak the things which are proper for sound doctrine. And the thing that I want to remind us is this. This is the Apostle Paul talking to Titus. Amen. He says, ask for you. Ask for you. And if you go back and you read Titus chapter 1, what he's telling them is, hey, look, there's some people that don't, not everybody do right. Amen. Not everybody. Some people are legalistic. Some people are giving you one thing and living another way. But he said, but ask for you. As for you, so I receive it for me. He said, but as for you, Chauncey, amen. He said, but as for you, speak the things. And when we look at that word speak, We need to understand that it's actually saying teach, because to speak, just like I'm in your hearing today, is to teach if you're willing to receive. And again, I'm trying to help us because I've made, amen, so many bad decisions, amen. I've been a bad example for so many of you. Amen. And I take ownership of my portion of being a bad example, man. Forgive me, brother. Forgive me. Amen. But maybe if more men would take ownership of raising, amen, it don't have to be your DNA. Amen. It can be in your neighborhood, but begin to invest in our young men. Amen. Begin to invest in them and tell them that, man, you can be something. You can be somebody. Amen. Forgive me for being a bad example. Hallelujah. Now hear this, it says, but as for you, speak the things, in other words, teach the things which are proper and sound doctrine. So just because you don't like me telling you that, hey, look, man, all them tattoos in your face or whatever, just because you don't like it, don't mean that it's not good. Don't mean the stuff that I'm telling you is not good. But again, I failed you because I didn't invest enough time in you for you to even respect my opinion, or for you to even respect the things that I'm telling you. Amen. So forgive me. Amen. I ain't mad at you. I'm just telling you that I had a role to play. Amen. You're not by yourself. Amen. Because again, teach the things which are proper. That's just not proper. Amen. It's not proper because one day you're going to want to live and you're going to find it difficult to really live with some of the decisions that you made. And I'm telling you now, no, I don't have some of the same things, amen, that you can see physically, but I'm telling you, there's some things that I'm ashamed of. There's some things that were a lot of areas in my life where I messed up. So I'm telling you, amen, that you can learn from me. You don't have to do the same things. Amen. Hallelujah. But teach the things which are proper for sound doctrine. Amen. He says, now listen to what he says in verse 2. That the older men, one more time, that the older men be sober, reverent, temperate, sound in faith, in love, in patience. Amen. So what he's telling us is, he's talking to Timothy. He's talking to this young preacher. Amen. He's talking to this young man. He's like, hey, listen, there's going to be some older people that you're going to have to teach. Amen. Because he says, speak these things. Remember that now. He said, there's some older people that you're going to have to teach. Now, the scripture tells us to bring up a child in the way that he should go. Amen. But it never gives an age. And here we find the older men. In other words, they were older than Titus. Come on now. They were older than Titus. So he's saying, but listen to what he says. He says that the older men be sober. Amen. Be reverent, temperate, sound in faith, in love, in patience. So he's telling them, hey, you got to teach these older men. Now you need to understand that there's a way to come at these older men to teach them. So you say, well, what that got to do with anything, Apostle Craig? What are you trying to say? I'm trying to tell us, amen, see it not strange that when we walk our blocks, amen, when we go into our cities, that there are still some older men that's acting like children. Hello, somebody. Amen. There are still some older men that have not got it. So we need to teach them. Amen. We need to teach these older men, and they need to be willing to learn. Amen. So it has nothing to do with, man, I'm grown. Amen. All of us are grown. Hallelujah. Amen. I believe those that listen today, you're grown. But the fact of the matter is, amen, you need to be taught. Amen. Because you're supposed to be an example to the younger men. Amen. But if y'all hang it together, if you can't, if they have no respect for you as a mature adult, amen, or someone elder to them, amen, then they're not going to listen to what you say, because y'all down like 4 flat tires. In other words, you just my boy. Amen. And that's the thing with some of us fathers. Amen. We've gotten down and tried to be friends. Amen. With our sons and friends with some of the boys in the neighborhood. Amen. But I'm not your friend. Amen. I'm here to be an example for you. Amen. To live proper, godly, and good lives. Amen. In other words, to tell you when you're wrong, to lift you up. Amen. To encourage you when you're right. Amen. To speak some good things down inside of you. Amen. That you may live a life, amen, of good health and prosperity, amen, in the word of God and through the word of God. Hello, somebody. Amen. But the thing, once again, forgive me, Chauncey, for being a bad example. Hallelujah. Now, let's deal with this text. Once again, it says that the older men be sober, reverent, temperate, sound in faith and love. Amen. But it goes on to say, verse 3 says, the older women, likewise. Amen. In other words, you are to teach the older women. You to teach the older women. Notice that. The older women. It's in there. Amen. And what so many preachers get in trouble and find themselves trapped. Amen. They be trying to teach the younger women. Yeah. Now I know that a preacher right there. They try to teach the younger women. Amen. Well, I need to meet with you on such and such night. I need to talk. That's not your job. Amen. Now I'm not saying be afraid to talk with young women or nothing like that. But you make sure that hey, depending on what it is, because listen, I'm just showing you in the text, amen. I know sometimes we just blow right over the top of this, but it says, the older women likewise, that they may be reverent in behavior, not slanderers, amen. In other words, amen, not devil workers, amen, not working for the devil, nor giving to so much wine. And when you read that so much wine, I need you to understand that, you know, some people say, well, when you read that, it's okay to drink, amen, because it says not so much wine. But when you research it and understand what he's saying, what he's really saying to us is that nothing, that you won't be in bondage to anything, because you'll meet some people right now that say, man, I can't function without a drink. So in other words, so much wine. In other words, you're in bondage to so much wine. So don't drink so much wine. Don't be in bondage to so much stuff. Amen. Because again, that's what he's referring to, being in bondage. Amen. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. I'm just trying to help us. It says, not giving too much wine, teachers of good things. Amen. So in order for you to be a teacher of good things, you got to learn some good things. So here he's talking to the women. So the thing that I want us to understand is, again, as preachers, as leaders, as men, amen, it's okay that we minister to the crowd, because that's what we do. We minister to the church. But when it comes to teaching these young women, listen to what she says, right? Listen to what the scripture says, what Paul is telling Timothy. He said that they may admonish the young women to love their husband. So listen here, preacher. And listen, a male preacher, you can't teach that woman how to love her husband. Amen. That's for the older women, married women, to show them. Amen. So don't you tell me, well, I need to meet with you so I can help you and your husband. So I can help. No. But I just want to meet with you. I don't want to meet with the husband. No, that's not your job. That's the older women's job. Hello, somebody. Amen. But listen to what he says. To love their husbands, to love their children, to be discreet, chaste, homemakers. You can't teach them to be no homemaker. Amen. To be good, to be obedient to their own husband. Amen. You can't teach them that. That's for the older women. Amen. So the thing that it's a lot in here, but the thing I'm trying to point out to us is, forgive me. Amen. Forgive me for being a bad example. Hallelujah. But the thing, so once again, amen, where I want to direct us to is, again, preachers, don't you be out there trying to teach these young ladies how to be, how to take care of their husband. Leave that to the older women. But if you teach the older women, they'll turn around and teach the young women, amen. And some of their experience, that's why they're older, amen, they'll be able to minister to those young women. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. So back to the point at hand, amen. Everybody needs to be taught, not only the older men, but also the older women. And the older women, likewise, amen, they're gonna teach the young women how to encourage in being their homes, how to build up their homes, how to build up their children, amen. But I'm telling you, this thing has been lacking in the church. Why? Because we're so busy trying to get to the church, amen. We're so busy trying to take care of our own. We're too busy trying to work our job that we're not investing, amen, into the younger people. And I'm guilty. Hallelujah. But as of today, I'm going to do a new, amen. I've made up my mind. I'm going to be different about this thing. I'm going to be diligent, amen, in ensuring, amen, to sow into the lives of some young people, amen, because I have failed them. I've been a bad example. Now, I can't say I've been a bad example because I've been hanging on the corner. I've been drinking. I've been just lusting and falling over. Now, I haven't been a bad example that way, amen, but absent, I have been. Absent, I have been, amen. Absent, yeah, absent. That's a bad example because I'm supposed to teach you. Amen. I'm supposed to instruct you. And I'm saying to the Lord, forgive me. Amen. For being a bad example. And I say to you, once again, forgive me for being a bad example. Now, yeah, I can continue to read it, to go through the text and point some things out to you. But I really just wanted to put this thing into your hearing today. Amen. That us as men, We have a responsibility to the young men behind us, amen. And I ain't talking about just the ones in your house, but I'm talking about your relatives, amen. Your neighbors. We have a responsibility to teach those young men. We have a responsibility to pour into them. We don't get to determine whether they want to receive it or not. Amen. But whenever you get the chance, you speak life into them. And it's not about demanding. Because remember, he's talking to Titus and telling him to teach the older men. So you know you can't come at no old school cat, no any kind of way. But we need to understand that you can't come at nobody any kind of way. Amen. So there's a way to teach. There's a way to instruct. So, but we want to do everything that we do. We want to do it in love. But the last thing we want to do is be absent and not do what God has required of us and to teach these young men. Hallelujah. Amen. And he didn't say that they had to be believers. Come on, somebody. He didn't say that they had to be in your church. Amen. But we have a responsibility, amen, to teach the young men. And women, you have a responsibility to teach the young women. Hallelujah. But you got to get learned first. Just like men, we have to be learned first. Amen. We have to be the example. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. I love you.